Hi! Good evening, everybody, and welcome to your Hump Glorious Hump Day Wednesday Turning Point for Wednesday, March the 23rd, 2022, Episode 192. Today we're going to be talking about hardships. Beginning with Romans 5, 3 and 4, recommended reading is Romans 8, 28 and 29. And our turning point is from D.A. Carson. And our Bible reading is 1 Samuel chapters 4 through 7. So 4, 5, 6, 7. So if you're excited about this, we'll smash the like button. What did you do today? If you wasn't working, what special thing did you do today? Subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that 100 subscriber mark by April the 18th, which is my birthday, which is now 26 days away. So. Yeah, 26. But hardships. Romans 5, 3 and 4. Beginning with, and not only that, but we also glory in tribulations, knowing that tribulation produces perseverance, and perseverance character, and character hope. So the topic of suffering is not part of the Christian gospel message, so sometimes new Christians are surprised to learn that it is an expected part of the Christian experience. And Jesus said in John 16:33, in the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. And Paul wrote in Acts 14:22, we must, through many tribulations, enter the kingdom of God. And two verses from the famous passage of Romans 8. I think it's the last half of Romans 8. I think it's like verse 20. Maybe 20 to 30, whatever, the ending. 31, I think it's. I think it's like 28 to 20, 31, I believe. But turning your Bibles to that passage of Romans 8, verses 28 and 29. Okay, I think. It's 31 through 39 is the good part of the passage, but 28 and 29 is right on in that sex, right in that group. Not in that in 31 to 39, but it's linked up with it. So, but verses 28 and 29, it says, and we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to his purpose. For whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. So there are two kinds of suffering Christians. There are two kinds of suffering Christians will encounter. So there are two kinds of suffering, excuse me, that Christians will encounter as they follow Christ. First, the hardships of living in a fallen world. Hardships experienced by everyone, Christian or not. And second, the hardships we encounter for being followers of Christ, more rightly called persecution. So all persecution is a hardship, but not all hardships are the result of persecution for our faith. If you understand the difference in that. So whatever the cause of our hardships, the Bible says they have a godly purpose to ultimately conform us to the image of Christ, as we just read in Romans 8, 28 and 29. So hardships produce perseverance, character, and hope. Hope being the anchor of our soul. Hebrews 6:19. So when you encounter hardship, embrace it as a tool. And it will help you become more like Jesus. Amen? So today's turning point is from D.A. Carson. Initials D.A. and then Carson with the last name. And he says, or he or she says, because usually when you see abbreviations, you don't know whether it's a male or female. So he or she says, there is a certain kind of maturity that can be attained only through the discipline of suffering. Woo. That's a good one. I like that one. So coming up tomorrow, in our passages tomorrow, first off, episode 668, part 1, we will be in the next It's All About God video, which right now I do not know what number it is. I have to do some research to find the last God video, God series video that we've done, which I don't know at this time. But before I get to it, I'll find it so I'll know what number. So, but we will, for your blessed, thankful Thursday, March 24th, episode 668, part 1, we're going to be talking about God's Son in the Old Testament, which will be another It's All About God video. And we'll begin with Psalm 2, verse 7. Coming up tomorrow in 668 part 2 in our Daily Bread, we're going to be talking about And Seven Others from Dave Brannon, derived from James 2, 1 through 4. And then coming up tomorrow night in your Turning Point, episode 193, we're going to be talking about your Blessed Thankful Thursday, March 24th, Turning Point, episode 193. We're going to be talking about Safe in His Hand. Starting with Mark 12:36. Our recommended reading is John 10:28-29. And an unknown person has, it's the turning point is an unknown quote. Don't know who said it. Or where it came from. And then our Bible reading is 1 Samuel chapters 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Ooh, that's like a weekend passage. But you got to read all five of them in one day. Maybe some of them are short. Maybe some are short passages. But that's what we'll do tomorrow. We got It's All About God, the next one, God's Son in the Old Testament, and Seven Others in the Daily Bread, and Safe in His Hands in the Turning Point. But with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe. And all you say and do in 2022. And until tomorrow, and before I go any further, tomorrow is my mom and dad's 50th wedding anniversary. So I hope you tune in to any of the videos tomorrow and wish them a happy anniversary, a happy golden anniversary. And I will be sure to pass along the messages to them. I think my mother would appreciate that, with strangers telling, or people outside of sending a card or something, or calling them, get a message from a unknown person and saying happy anniversary, happy 50th wedding anniversary. But I'll be sure to pass them along the messages. If you will do so, I thank you. But until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Hump Day, Wednesday evening. Come back tomorrow for another Blessed Thankful Thursday, which also is my mom and dad's 50th wedding anniversary. So, I should have waited till that part, but I look forward to seeing all the messages pouring in on the comment in the comments, and I'll pass them along to them. But with that said, but until tomorrow, goodbye.